Hello students, I welcome you all once again to the e-learning sessions of Automobile Engineering. Myself Hardik Shah, and during this lecture series we will discuss some interesting topics in the subject of automotive electricals and electronics. Okay, we have already started a new chapter and we have already discussed about the power window and its working. Okay, so in today's video we will discuss about the central locking system. Okay, you can say central car locking system. I hope you will see this video till the end to completely understand this topic and gain your skills in automobile engineering. I also request you to note down any queries which arises during the lecture and ask me in a comment section. I will try to respond all the queries as soon as possible. So now let's start our today's video. So what is central locking system? You must have heard this system. That means you are only putting one switch from the car key and the door will be locked. Okay, so the main function of the central locking system is controlling the access authorization at all the times, but it also must cover the following actuations. Okay, actuation of the opening handles or lifting, braking and locking the doors during the closing operation. Okay, so the central locking system includes simple components like this: locking bar on a body pillars, doors, that means door lock mechanisms, and dedicated mechanical and electrical parts. Thereafter, electrical components required to access the authorization facility, and a radio remote control for the remote operations. Okay, depending on their location, further dividing that can be a side door assembly, trunk assembly and the hood assembly. Okay, these three are also operated by the central lock. Okay, door assembly consists of the catch, pawl and the latch. So the door lock strikes is attached to the body pillar. Under closing operation, the door lock strikers get caught by the latch and hold it the closed position and centers the door. So the pawl positively locks the catch in the position. This lock condition is automatically aborted when opening procedure begins. Okay, for this process, the force acting on inner or the outer door handles are transferred to the pole and causes the catch release to open the door. So the door lock strikes stay in a position while catch swivel go into the open position. Okay, these three components are actually working all the system. So in this case, operation methods central locking system consists of the two types of actuators. One is electromagnetic, second is pneumatic. Let's discuss electromagnetic. So electromagnetic actuators rely on solenoid switches, which actually locks and unlocks the door using going in the both directions. Though in electronic module, on this kind of the system, two types of arrangements are used. First one uses the separate relay for each of the action taking by the system, one dedicated to open and another dedicated to close the door. Okay, both of them are controlled by the transistor switching the circuit operated by the capacitor. That means it is actually storage of the energy device for the necessary operating system. Okay, which is releasing the current necessarily to activate the lock. Another type uses two capacitors and two relays working as a tandem. Okay, one pair is responsible for locking and another pair is responsible for the unlocking of the door. So when the circuit is closed, the current is discharged from the capacitor and the lock is either open or either closed. Okay, this was about the electromagnetic. Next is pneumatic actuators. So pneumatic actuators are driven by the pneumatic central unit, which controls the vacuum or pressure pump. So when the vacuum is applied, actuators are acting on a mechanism lock or unlock the door. So the vacuum pump is driven by the electric motor, which is working in both the directions. So forward rotation creates the compressor action, that means door opens, while the backward rotation creates vacuum, that means door will close. Okay, now polarity on the electric motor is changed by change over the control switch. In most modern cars, electrical locking systems are replaced mechanical unit due to the demand of the quality and reliability. Okay, the main advantage of the electrical locking doors are: it is symmetrical in design, smaller and lighter in the comparison to the mechanical unit, only one lock version per vehicle is needed, Thereafter, individual encoding at the end of the production line, so it will give the safer side, and door handles no longer move outwards. Okay. Other supplementary functions like an interior light or status indicator can easily be introduced in the electrical locking system, because the locks are equipped with electronics which can carry out these functions also. Okay, communication with the locks, power supply and the security systems takes place via a simple data bus, or you can say simple bus system. Okay, there is also one more, that is engine immobilizers. What is that? So an immobilizer is an electronic anti-theft security device which prevents engine start by unauthorized person unless the correct key or fob is placed in the ignition barrel. Okay. If the correct key is used, transponder inside the key sends the signal to the reader, which transfers the signal to the receiver. Okay. Now, if the signal is recognized by the ECU, the system allows user to start the engine. If not, the immobilizer will disable few car systems which is necessary to start the engine, usually fuel injection, fuel pump and ignition components. Okay, so the immobilizer is strongly connected to the car's security system, so any unauthorized access to the car that is detected by the security system, that means movement detectors, infrared sensors, sonic sensors and many others depending on the security system, it will actually automatically trigger the immobilizer of the car and any other alarm aims such as horn and the flashing headlights, which will warn the other persons which are around the car. Okay, so car alarm can be activated by the infrared signals generated by the fob or keyring and received by the optical sensing unit placed somewhere in the car. Now, another type is radio control system. Radio wave is created by the fob and the key and the received by the car antenna, which is quite often car heated rear window. Okay. Now, in both the examples, the signal is unique for the each car, and only this one signal is recognized by the ECU, and then only it will operate the car. Okay. So, alarm system uses few different types of the sensors to protect the car. One is shock sensor, which is detecting any vehicle movement. Next is ultrasonic sensor, that car interior is covered by the ultrasonic signal. Any change in the strength of the signal pattern activates this alarm. Thereafter, voltage drop or current drain signal. Now, any drop of the voltage which is disconnecting the battery or current drain, or that means switching of the interior lights, it will activate the alarm. Thereafter, infrared signals, it will detect any disruption of the beam transmitted between the two points inside the car. Okay. Thereafter, direct earth contact, which is detected by the bonnet, boot and the door switches when the earth contact happens. Okay. So, that's it in today's session. I wish you got the clear idea about the central locking system and the different devices inside it. Okay. Therefore, if you have any more to know or have any specific query, please let me know. I will sure to respond as soon as possible. Okay. I hope you like this video. Thank you so much. Stay tuned. Goodbye.